scans confirm numerous life signs aboard the dive. No response to communications. I suggest using extreme caution, squadron leader. Autopilot engaged. Please stand by. Auto docking system enabled. Collating. Collating. Hangar 1 access granted. SME online. Shutting down pilot interface. Goodbye.
Sequence initiated. Heavy Fighter 21, CDF registration number 3, S451, Alpha will now dock with service pad 3. Alert. Hangar 1 emergency access granted. Welcome back, Squadron Leader Zach Thomas. The CDF lineup has been compromised. Please proceed to the bridge on deck 1 for further information. Caution! The CDF lineup has been evacuated. For your own personal safety, you are advised to evacuate the ship immediately. Warning. Hostile alien life forms detected in the service area. Emergency. Fire and maintenance. The fire must be extinguished immediately before full decompression of the ship. Compartment pressurizing. Please stand by. Compartment pressurizing. Please stand by. Compartment pressurized. Emergency. Fire and maintenance. The fire must be extinguished immediately before full decompression of the ship. Full decompression of the ship. Will commence in 3, minus 10. Minutes. Warning. Hostile life forms detected. Warning, the Goliath is declared uninhabitable. Evacuate the ship. Forms detected on decks 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 7. Compartment pressurized. Emergency. Fire and maintenance. The fire must be extinguished immediately before full decompression of the ship. Door is not operational. Warning. Hostile life forms detected. Warning, the Goliath is declared uninhabitable. Evacuate the ship. Door is not operational. The fire is out of control. Deck 7 must be decompressed in order to extinguish the fire. Locate the control room and activate the decompression system for Deck 7. Non-human life forms get coupled. Contact one, two, three, four, five, and seven. Decompression activated. You have 1 minute until decompression of Deck 7. Warning, the Goliath is declared uninhabitable. Evacuate the ship. Non-human life forms detected. Pressurizing. Please stand by. Compartment pressurized. Non-human life forms detected. Warning, the Goliath is declared uninhabitable. Evacuate the ship.
Door is not operational. Alert. Operations section still in lockdown. Most doors are not operational. Decks 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 are affected. Reset lockdown status on remote terminal in the main access corridor. Non-human life forms detected on decks 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 7. Reset lockdown status on a remote terminal in the main access corridor to reactivate access to all doors. Compartment pressurizing. Please stand by. Access erratic. Remote access terminal in the main access corridor and disengage the lockdown. Attention. Non-human life forms detected in the main access corridor. The Goliath is declared uninhabitable. All crew members still on board must evacuate immediately. Attention. Non-human life forms detected in the main access port and disengaged. All doors are now operational. Opening all doors and personnel. Operations. Engineering. Cargo hold. Warning. Numerous doors have been deactivated or powered down with operations and personnel. Compartment pressurizing. Please stand by. Compartment pressurized. Warning, the Goliath is declared uninhabitable. Evacuate the ship. Pressurizing. Please stand by. Compartment pressurized. Non-human human lifeforms detected on decks 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 7. Warning, the Goliath is declared uninhabitable. Evacuate the ship.
Thank you.
Engaging. All functional doors are now active in operations. Personnel, cargo hold and engineering.
Playing back the last 8 logs in the system.
Captain's log, standard Earth year 2368, March 12th, 1333 local time. Location, the ICARS system. We've just jumped into normal space and have entered the ICARS system. We've still received no communications from the ICARS orbital or the colony. At our current speed, we should reach ICARS 3 in just over 23 hours. I've just dispatched a solo fighter to investigate a ping on the radar as we enter normal space. It may be nothing, but with losing communications with ICARS 3, we need to take all necessary precautions. The blip was located near ICARS 9 in a small, dense asteroid field. The fighter will be out of comms range by the time we arrive at ICARS 3, so I've instructed the pilot to investigate the area and return to the Goliath, which is a 3-day round trip. Feel sorry for that guy being stuck in a fighter cockpit for 3 days. But at least he'll be on the other side of the solar system if this shit hits the fan. Captain's log supplement. Off. Standard Earth year 2368, March 12th, 2007 local time. Location, the ICARS system. Still. Captain's log, standard Earth year 2368, March 13th, 1201 local time. Location, the ICARS system. Still no contact from the outpost or orbital station at ICARS 3. Long-range preliminary scans show there are plenty of life signs on the orbital and on the colony. We are entering ICARS 3 space and should arrive at the orbital station in just over a half an hour. We're as ready as we can ever be if we do run into trouble. Thank you.